Queen. This is my show, How Everything Changes and All Stays the Same. It's at Baltimore Clayworks. It's been up from July 15th until August 28th, 2021. So yeah, this is it. This is in the gallery. There's a few different rooms that it occupies. So I was just gonna talk about a few pieces. This is a piece called Forgotten Corner, Flaccid Bike. It was a piece that took a while to make. There's a lot of different material components to it. So there's some paper mache pieces, there's some sewn work, and then there's also ceramic components. So it's kind of an assemblage of all those different materials. And I was thinking about my old apartment and how I had this space that I would just kind of throw stuff in and would kind of forget about, and it didn't really feel like it was part of my apartment, but it was very much me. Like, for example, a bike that I had originally bought to become a biker, and then I never rode it. And the wheels became all deflated and deformed. And yeah, I don't know. I think one of the elements in the show thematically that I was thinking about was how you can have these relationships to space, or kind of a disconnect from space also. From like the Baltimore Clayworks community. So that was one of the first things I did when I got here, was I asked for any donated fabric. And then I took a lot of old shirts and window blinds and pretty much anything I could find, and I would rip it up and then assemble it together based on a cartoon, which would be the drawing of the piece. And also for these works, I had an assistant named Rachel Austin, who was awesome, and there's no way these could have gotten finished without her. So I have three of these. This piece is called Death Display. It's probably my favorite tapestry I've done thus far. And it has a lot of different components too. These were press molding pieces I created, all the fish and crabs and stuff. And I was thinking about, I've always been really fascinated with the seafood selection at grocery stores, especially since I went to Italy, and they have it so nicely displayed. And America doesn't exactly do that, but they try. But I don't really like seafood personally, so it's always kind of pretty and disgusting to me. So that's what I was thinking about. What started off, I built a wooden frame, and then I attached these little screws into it. And so these screws attached to those is the warp. So the warp is just vertical pieces of, this was carpet yarn, I think. So it's just really strong. And then starting from the bottom up, I will weave the pieces back and forth in between the warp. So that's called the weft. And this piece has a lot of different materials that were used. So the wood was covered with this like jute. This was the first piece I made, so it was right when the pandemic started, so I couldn't get fabric anywhere. So there were some like beer bottles that got cut to make these weird little embellishments. There's a lot of different beads. There's some old blinds that I painted. Probably one of my favorite additions was this ankle brace because I twisted my ankle, and so that worked out to be perfect for the corners. She's awesome, and I thought if we could preserve her in a pickle jar, that would be really cool.